I hope you all are well at your home. This is your maths class for grade 6. Before starting our study, let us take a pledge against COVID-19. I, Mansi, commit to be vigilant and bear in mind all times the risk to myself and my colleagues from COVID-19. I promise to take all necessary precautions that prevent the spread of this deadly virus. I promise to follow and encourage others to follow the key COVID appropriate behaviors, to always wear a mask, face cover, especially when in public places, to maintain a minimum distance of 6 feet from others, to wash my hands frequently and thoroughly with soap and water. Together, we will win this fight against COVID-19. So now, we are going to start our third chapter, integer subtraction and addition and subtraction of the integer. So firstly, our first question came in mind, what are the integers? So simply, integers are the collection of all the negative as well as the positive numbers. So starting with integers, now the integers are all the negative and all the positive. The set of positive and negative number, it is called the integers. So we are going to start our exercise. So our first question is it possible to say which is the largest number in the set of integer? We cannot say what is the largest number, because we don't know what is the last number in our number system. So the answer is simply no. Next is, does every positive integer have a corresponding negative number? Yes, every negative number have its corresponding positive number. So that is yes. Next is, what is the corresponding negative integer for 1001? So the negative integer for 1001 is -1001. What is the sum of these two integers? What is the sum? That will be 0 always. Next is, if going north is considered positive, what will be its negative mean? In our system, we have read that north, south, east, west. If they considered north as positive, the negative of north will be south. Next is, if gaining weight considered positive, what is its negative? If we gain weight, that is considered as positive, but if we lose weight, that is called negative. So lose weight is negative. Next is, if profit of rupees 50 is written as plus rupees 50, how will you write loss of rupees 50? So simply, loss of rupees 50 will be minus 50. Next is, how will you write 8 degrees Celsius below zero? As we have read already, that the numbers below zero are negative and the number above the zero are positive. So simply, that is written as -8 degrees Celsius. Next is, how will you write 100 meter below the sea level? Simply 100 meters, negative 100 meters. The reason to write it, because we measure the height upside always positive and downside always negative. So they said that, how will you write -100 meter below the sea level? So when we move below the sea level, that term becomes negative. So our answer will be -100 meter. So our next exercise is ordering of integer. So what is the ordering of integer? If we move from 0 to 5, the number becomes greater. Means 1 is greater than 0, 2 is greater than 1, 3 is greater than 2, 4 is greater than 3, 5 is greater than 4, and up to so on. Next is smaller. When we move from right to left, the number becomes smaller when we are talking about positive integers. So that is 4 is smaller than 5, 3 is smaller than 4, 2 is smaller than 3, 4, 5, up to so on. Similarly, when moving to negative integers, the greater term similar and the smaller term is similar. Meaning that minus 1 is greater than minus 2. The thing is that the number of negative terms, when we are talking about negative terms, the smallest negative term is the greater it is. Reason behind it is close to 0. Minus 1 is greater than minus 2. Minus 2 is greater than minus 3. Minus 3 is greater than minus 4. Minus 1 is smaller than minus 2. Minus 3 is smaller than minus 2. Next is, any positive integer is greater than any negative integer. So, if we are having any negative number and any positive number, when we compare them, the positive number is always greater than the negative one. Next is, 0 is less than positive integer but more than negative integer. 0 is always smaller when we are talking about positive integer, and 0 is always greater when we are talking about negative integer. Next is, the greater an integer, the smaller is its corresponding negative value. So 10 is greater but its corresponding negative value is minus 10, which will be smaller as compared to 5. Means negative term, jitni zyada choti negative term hogi, utni hi zyada uski value hogi. Because here it is minus 10 and minus 5. Minus 5 is always greater than minus 10. Next, moving to absolute value. What is the absolute value? This sign, this is called module. So when we take the module of any term, that becomes positive. If it is minus 8, when we write the absolute value of minus 8, that would be 8. The absolute value of 0 is always 0. So 0 is neither positive nor negative. 0 is a neutral number. 0 is having no sign, neither positive nor negative. So moving to our exercise, our first question is, fill in the boxes with symbol greater than or less than. Simply, 4 and minus 2, as we have read that every positive number is greater than negative number, so 4 is greater. Next is minus 1 and 0. We have read that 0 is always greater than negative numbers. Next is 0 and 5. We have read that all the positive numbers are greater than 0. Next is 3 and minus 3. So 3 is greater than minus 3. Every positive integer is greater than the negative one. Next is minus 1 and 5. For every positive number is greater than negative number. Similarly in this. And here it is minus 6 and minus 8. As we have read earlier, the smaller the number, it is negative, the greater is its value. So minus 6 is greater than minus 8. Next is, arrange the following ascending order. What is the ascending order? Write down the short, greater, greater and the greatest. For example, taking this question, 6 minus 8. Minus 7, 8, minus 3, 0. So minus 8 is the smallest term. The next is minus 7. The next is minus 3. The next is 0. The next is 6. And the last one is 8. So what is the ascending order? We have to start from the smallest term and we have to end at the greatest term. Next is, using the number line, find the integers. So how to find our number at the number line? Let me show you. First is 5 more than 7. So firstly, what is more than? More than means we have to add simply. 5 plus 7, that is 12. Now draw our number line. What is a number line? A line containing negative as well as positive numbers. That is called a number line. 0, 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. So that is 5 more than 7. Starting from 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that is 12. As we have read that it is 12. 5 plus 7 is 12. So simply we have to move from 5 to 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So when we are moving from 5 to 7, that the number comes 12 as we have read earlier. Next is, let me take 8 less than 0. So what is 8 less than 0? 0 se 8 come. That is minus 8. So we have to draw minus 8. Here it is 0, 1, 2, 3. These are the positive numbers. These are the negative ones. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9. So 0 less than 8 would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then 8. So that would be minus 8. 0 less than 8, we have to move from 0 to minus 8. Next is 6 more than minus 6. 6 more than minus 6. So that would be 6 minus 6, which is 0. So we are having minus 6. Minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So simply they said 6 less than minus 6. So 6 less than minus 6 means we have to move this side. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So our answer will be 0 itself. Next is 3 less than minus 5. 3 less than minus 5. So how to write less than? That is 5. Less than means we have to subtract simply. So that would be minus 5 minus 3. That will become minus 8. So simply minus 8, minus 7, minus 6, minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. 0, 1, 2, 3. So that is minus 5 less than minus 3. We are having here. So we have to move 3 steps backwards. That is 1, 2 and then 3. That is 5 minus 3, which is equals to minus 8. So this is done. Next is write all integers between. First is 0 and 5. So how to write the in between? Write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These are the number which comes in between. Next is minus 1 and 1. Minus 1 and 1. That is minus 1, 0, 1. So simply you have to write all the integers in the same way. Next is write the absolute value of the following. How to write the absolute value? Simply take the module. What is module? That is, first let me take, that is 10. When we take the module of 10, it is always 10. Next is minus 10. When we take the module of negative term, it is becoming positive. So our answer is again 10. Module means we have to make the negative term into positive. That's all for your exercise 3.1 and 3.2. I hope you all understand. Thank you. Have a nice day.